Live for God Studio Productions.
This is Cooking with Brian, a cooking show with food that actually tastes great.
Hi friends, welcome to Cooking with Brian. Today we're going to do a very simple recipe that about anybody can make. It's pretty easy and it's absolutely delicious. Today we are going to fix barbecued pork roast in the crock pot. Very easy and simple recipe. And here's how you do it, friends. Okay, friends, all you need to make this barbecued pork roast is a crock pot. You need a pork roast. This happens to be a pork shoulder blade roast, boneless, 3.68 pounds. You can also use any other kind of pork roast. Could be a butt roast, could be whatever you want it to be. Whatever they get for sale or whatever, that's fine. Pork tastes good. They always say from the rooter to the tooter. That's what they say. And everything in between, because, you know, a lot of times you'll see the roasted pig, you know, and they'll eat it from head to toe. That's the way that it, you know, people are. They eat it everything. Except for I do not put my stamp on. People that eat nasty pickled pig's feet, you people are disgusting. That's some disgusting stuff, dude. Nasty. I could never do it, sorry. But this stuff is good, though. So we're going to do this. Oh, and the only other ingredients you need is water. And then you want to get you a bottle of the number one barbecue sauce in the world. There's nothing like it. Absolutely nothing like this. This is world famous Joe's. Let's see if we can let you see this. World famous Joe's barbecue, Kansas City. You want to get you a bottle of that. Just look for it on the internet if you don't have it in your location. There are websites in Kansas City that sells this, and you can get it for about $5 a bottle shipped to you. Okay, friends, the first thing you want to do is remove your lid on your crock pot. Go ahead and take your roast and drop it in here in the package, because we're going to go over this. Okay, what you want to do is go ahead and slice your bag open, friends, with it in the crock pot. And the reason why we're doing this is this stuff is a bloody mess. Okay, go ahead and dump that in there and throw your plastic away without making a mess. Okay, friends, then you'll notice that on this pork roast there happens to be a net all the way around the pork roast. You want to go ahead and take your knife and you want to kind of cut at it a little bit until you can get it to come off. Okay, now some roasts will tell you that you need to cook it with the fat side up, but heck, these things are fat all the way around the thing, so you're going to cook it for so long before you flip it and everything else, because every few hours, you know, maybe every 2 hours, flip it over or whatever. But after maybe 3 or 4 hours, you want to take a knife and kind of cut your roast into about 4 sections. Now you can use any size roast you want. as long as it fits in your crock pot. I'm sure that you can probably use more than one crock pot if you have a huge family and you have too much roast for the crock pot. You'd use multiple crock pots. However, here's your disclaimers for the day. If you blow your fuses, it's your fault. You take full responsibility. If you cut yourself with knives, burn yourself, cut your neighbors, cut your family, your animals, or if anything bad happens, it's your fault. You take full responsibility using our recipes here at Cooking with Brian. If your house goes up in flames, it's your fault. You take full responsibility. I'm innocent. You're guilty always on Cooking with Brian. That's a big 10-4. Okay, friends, you want to start by adding some hot tap water in here. You can go ahead and turn your crock pot on low. Okay, you don't want to go all the way over the top with the water. You see where we're at? We got it almost to the top. It's about, I would say, 85-90% submerged in water. Okay, friends, then you want to take your world famous Joe's barbecue sauce and go ahead and dump the whole thing in here on top of your roast. I want to have a second bottle available, one that is for adding to it. However, it's still extremely, extremely good without adding extra barbecue sauce, but there's nothing like fresh barbecue sauce added to it after it's done cooking. Now for sides and stuff, you might be able to fix some kind of fried potatoes or even maybe baked potatoes. Salads go very well with this. You can have whatever you want, whatever you think goes great with it, you know. Potatoes is an awesome option. Salads are always good. I'm sure if you really wanted to, you could fix some vegetables or something to go alongside of it. Maybe some good green beans or corn or carrots, whatever you wanted to. But we're not adding any vegetables in this roast itself. Okay, friends, you want to put your lid on. It's already on low. You want this roast started as early as possible in the morning, maybe 8 o'clock or before, to be done around 5, 6 o'clock. Okay, friends, you want to go ahead and after about 3 hours, cut your roast in about 4 pieces. Cut it in half and then cut those other 2 pieces in half. Cook on low for about 5 hours. And then you want to cook it on high for about 3.5 hours or so. If you have an extremely large roast that was bigger than what I have, you might want to get up pretty early and start it real early in the morning, like 6 o'clock or something if it's a huge roast. But it'll turn out perfect if you cook it on low for 3 hours, cut it 4 pieces, stick it back in, let it cook, you know, for about 2 more hours or so on low, and then for approximately 3.5 hours, cook it on high the remainder of the way, and it'll come out absolutely perfect. You want to make sure you have an extra bottle of world famous Joe's barbecue sauce, because it is absolutely the bomb to dip into the fresh. You know, it already tastes good by itself and already absorbs the barbecue sauce it was cooked with, but to add more barbecue sauce that you can freshly dip into just sets it off. Okay, friends, and that's how you make the best barbecued pork roast that you can make. Nothing is better than world famous Joe's barbecue sauce, and we stand on it because it's delicious, absolutely delicious. Well, friends, we hope that was a blessing to you. We'll see you in our next video. Take care. Bye, y'all.